Okay, welcome to Lagos now, and we're taking a look at the economy in focus as the APC begins to reel out its scorecard. And to do that, I'm now being joined by Muda Yusuf. He's the Director General of the Lagos Chamber of Commerce and Industry. I want to thank you so much indeed for joining us.
Thank you very much.
In our Lagos studios, and happy Democracy Day.
Yeah, same to you.
You know, when I think about this, the scorecard of the APC, at the advent of this administration 3 years back, I remember very clearly that you were one of the advocates of this government, saying that you believe that this government is bringing that much-needed change, especially to the economy. 3 years down the line, has your mind changed?
Well, I think the position has changed partially.
Why?
First, some components of the expectations were not met. And it was not just only me. I think quite a number of Nigerians had very high expectations at the beginning of this administration. The goodwill was very high. But for some reasons, these expectations have not been met. First, if you look at the economy, you look at it from a number of perspectives. There's a pure economic perspective. There is a business perspective. Then there is the perspective of the ordinary man. Now, if you look at it from the purely economic angle, you'll be looking at some of the key macroeconomic indicators, some of which the president highlighted in his speech. To a large extent, some of these indicators look positive. At least they have been positive now for some time, although in the last 2 years, things were really bad until we had this upturn in oil price. If you look at the GDP growth, we were in recession. We came out of recession, and now, last quarter, we had about 2.11%. Percent GDP growth. In Q1 this year, we had a decline in the growth to 1.95. And if you look at even the components of the growth, quite a number of some critical sectors actually contracted, particularly in the non-oil sector of the economy. And this sector is a very critical sector because that is where our expectations about job creation and all of that will come from. Then if you look at the external sector, you'll be looking at the foreign reserves. Foreign reserves at the inception of this administration was about $23 billion. Now we are talking about 47.5 thereabout billion US dollars. So that is a substantial improvement. But whether it is because of what the government has done, or in spite of what the government has done, is a different discussion entirely. Then if you look at other macroeconomic indicators like inflation rate, it has been declining gradually. But again, if you look at the food component of inflation, it has not been very favorable.
Which is where the Nigerian masses are really
rational. Exactly. Because food prices is still high. And if you talk to the ordinary man, I think one of the challenges that the common man worries about is the food prices. Then, of course, you look at the issue of debt portfolio. It has increased significantly, close to, I think, over $60 billion as we speak. So on the economic front, looking at the economic indicators, I think there's been some average performance. And the performance has been driven largely by the recovery that we have seen in oil price and also by the fact that we have seen some stability in our oil output. Now, there is a business perspective, and that has to do with how conducive the business environment is. I must admit that quite a lot has been done in the area of ease of doing business. We have the Presidential Enabling Environment Council, which is chaired by the Vice President. A lot of work has gone into it, and a lot of dialogue has also taken place between the private sector and the Vice President and the economic team generally. We are seeing some improvement in the area of business registration, for instance. Quite a lot of people can now do some online registration of business. We are seeing some improvement in the area of visa issuance, especially for people that want to come to Nigeria. We have seen evidence of a lot of improvement in that area. But there are still a lot of challenges around the factors that are driving the cost of production.
For instance?
The operating cost. Energy is still a big issue for many businesses. Now, although we are celebrating the fact that oil price has gone up, but the flip side is that energy cost has also gone up. Because as oil price goes up, the cost of diesel is also going up. Diesel is now between 230 to 240 per liter. I know that quite a lot of work has also gone into trying to revamp the energy sector, but the impact is not yet felt. So energy remains a major issue in the competitiveness of enterprises. Then if you look at the cost of fund, one of the things or one of the reasons the Nigerian companies are not competitive is because of the high cost of fund. Because if you are taking funds at 25%, in some cases 30%, it is difficult to do any business profitably with that. And the funding situation has also created a financial inclusion problem, in the sense that some critical sectors of the economy cannot be supported by the funding that you have in the banking system. If you take the construction sector, for instance, you cannot fund a construction investment with an interest rate of 25%. If you take the property sector, you cannot fund property sector business with an interest rate of 25-30%.
To what extent has that hurt the economy?
Of course, it has made investment in those areas very difficult. And it has also, in a way, excluded a lot of private investors in the sector. And we are seeing situations in some sectors where, because of this funding challenge, some foreign investors also come into the system and virtually overrun even the domestic investors because of the funding advantage that they have. Even in manufacturing, it's not easy to fund a manufacturing investment at 30%, 25%. The same thing with agriculture.
But this has, been like that even before the advent of this administration. So what do you think is the missing link? What must be done by people like you, the economists, other chambers of commerce and industry, to ensure that that particular item that sees that interest borrowing rates are so high, what must be done about that?